first book of Samuel, the Lord said to Samuel, "Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I am sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem, for I have chosen my king from among his sons." As Jesse and his sons came to the sacrifice, Samuel looked at Eliab and thought, "Surely the Lord's anointed is here before him." But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not judge from his appearance or from his lofty stature, because I have rejected him. That as man sees, does God see, because man sees the appearance, but the Lord looks into the heart." In the same way, Jesse presented his seven sons before Samuel. But Samuel said to Jesse, "The Lord has not chosen any one of these." Then Samuel asked Jesse, "Are these all the sons you have?" Jesse replied, "There is still the youngest, who is tending the sheep." Samuel said to Jesse, "Send for him. We will not begin the sacrificial banquet until he arrives here." Jesse sent and had the young man brought to them. He was ruddy, a youth handsome to behold, and making a splendid appearance. The Lord said, "There, anoint him, for this is the one." Then Samuel, with a horn of oil in hand, anointed David in the presence of his brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon David. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Therefore it says, says, "Awake, O sleeper, and arise from the dead, and Christ will give you light." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will have the light of life.
Praise
totally in sin, and you are trying to teach us? Then they threw him out. When Jesus heard that they had thrown him out, he found him and said, Do you believe in the Son of Man? He answered and said, Who is he, sir? I may believe in him. Jesus said to them, You have seen him, and the one speaking with you is he. He said, I do believe, Lord. And he worshipped him. Then Jesus said, I came into this world for judgment, so that those who do not see might see, and those who do see might become blind. Some of the Pharisees who were with him heard this and said to him, Surely we are not also blind, are we? Jesus said to them, If you were blind, you would have no sin. But now you are saying, We see. Senses. Lent is our sorrow and repentance, and the penance we perform after receiving absolution. The form in this case is the words of absolution, prayed over us by the priest, which conclude, "And I absolve you from your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit," as the priest makes the sign of the cross over the penitent. And the sacrament of the anointing of the sick, the matter is anointing with the oil of the sick on the forehead and on the hands. The form is the prayer prayed by the priest at the same time. For example, John, through this holy anointing, may the Lord in his love and mercy help you through the grace of the Holy Spirit while anointing on the forehead with the cross. May the Lord who frees you from sin save you and raise you up as the hands are being anointed. In the sacrament of the holy orders in which deacons, priests, and bishops are ordained, the matter is the laying on of hands by the bishop on the head of the man being ordained. The form, which is the prayer of consecration immediately following the laying on of hands, which differs whether it is a deacon, a priest, or bishop, of course, who is being ordained. Part of the prayer of consecration for a priest is in particular, "Almighty Father, grant to this servant of yours the dignity of the priesthood. Renew within him the spirit of holiness. As a co-worker with the order of bishops, may he be faithful to the ministry that he receives from you, Lord God, and be to others a model of right conduct." In the sacrament of holy matrimony, the matter and form of the sacrament is the mutual self-giving and self-acceptance by the couple as they hold each other's right hands. One possible form was this one. The priest says to the bridegroom, John, "Do you take Mary as your wife? For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do you part." The bridegroom, of course, then says, "I do." The priest then says to the bride, "Mary, do you take John as your husband? For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do you part." The bride, of course, then says, "I do." When David was chosen by God as king, the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him when he was anointed by Samuel with oil. When the blind man was healed by Jesus in the gospel today, the healing of Jesus came to him through being anointed with a paste of clay washed in the pool of Siloam. He could feel the paste of clay on his eyes. He could feel Jesus touching his eyes. He could hear Jesus. He could feel the water washing off the clay. Yet he could not see Jesus. But Jesus came to him through touch and hearing. Every time we receive the sacraments, Jesus comes to us by touching our senses. And there is a visible sign of Jesus coming to us invisibly through his sacrament. Who would think that anointing with oil would be the signal for the Spirit of the Lord to fall mightily on David? Who would think that anointing with a paste of clay and washing would restore sight? But God uses the ordinary elements of nature to convey his power and healing to us in the sacraments of our faith. In every sacrament, Jesus comes to us invisibly, but still powerfully. As you receive the sacraments, you hear Jesus, and Jesus touches you. Jesus touched the blind man, and Jesus touches you when you receive the sacraments. Under these current unfortunate circumstances, the only way to receive Holy Communion now is spiritually. At this time, please pray with me the spiritual communion prayer. You can repeat with me at home. I wish, my Lord, to receive you with the purity, humility,
and devotion,
with which your most holy mother received you.
With which your most holy mother received you.
With the spirit and fervor of the saints.
With the spirit and fervor of the saints.
At Holy Communion time in this Mass, you can offer this prayer or one like it. Godspeed of the time we can pray once again together. And may God bless you and your families with many graces and blessings, keeping us all healthy and free of this virus. We profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death, was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father as the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. We now offer our prayers, our petitions to our Heavenly Father. We pray for the church and for all bishops that they may lead us by defending all our church teaches and believes. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our own parish family of St. Barnabas that this Lenten season may spiritually strengthen us to grow closer to God through the sacrament of penance and by our goodness to one another. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That more Catholics would pray before our Lord's true presence in the Holy Eucharist and realize when they do so, they are then in the presence of God, who made them, suffered for them, died, rose for them. We pray for war.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the conversion of our country, government, and media, that they may respect religious freedom and conscience of all, we pray for war.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who suffer disabilities, that they may inspire us to reach out and help them to experience the love of God, we pray for war.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died with the coronavirus, and as well as those who are currently suffering with it, we pray for war.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those health professionals that are working with the sick, that they may be protected from contracting the virus, we pray for war.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the attention of this Mass this afternoon, for the Shepherd and Bernard families, we pray for war.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the personal needs and intentions for the every side and silence of our hearts.
Thank you.
sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
We place before you with joy these lawful readings, which bring eternal remedy, O Lord, praying that we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as is fitting for the salvation of all the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your the sight of your divine majesties, let all of us in this participation be able to receive the most holy body of your Son, and may be filled with every grace and every blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest and sleep in peace. Grant them, Lord, we pray.
Jesus.